people on the floor. We didn't have a door, it was like a curtain. So I began to sing, and I started out just singing old hymns. And then I got to singing some praise choruses and this worship of the Lord. And I started singing, and I would sing this. I was singing this song. It's called "Jesus, You're the Center of My Joy."
Yeah.
This is how it goes. Jesus, You're the center of my joy.
Glory.
All that's good and perfect comes from You.
Glory.
You're the heart of my contentment. You're the hope for all I do, Lord Jesus.
Woo.
You're the center of singing it, but when I first come off of that thing, you know what it sounded like? Jesus.
Yeah, come on, man.
You're the center of my joy. That's all I can do. All that's good and perfect comes from You. Gasping for breath.
Yeah.
Tears are rolling down my face. You're the whoo.
Thank You, Jesus.
And the more I sing, God, they even say, oh, in the old time way, I felt my help come.
Yeah.
And I said, You're the heart of my contentment. And I felt strength keep on coming.
Yeah.
You're the hope for all I do.
Yes.
Lord Jesus. And I just got where I just started just basically speaking it out loud and making it louder. You're the center of my joy.
Yeah.
And I got to singing Beulah Man, the old rugged cross, and all these old songs I was raised up on. And next thing I know, a nurse comes to the curtain. And she said, Mr. Combs. They can't throw me out. I don't know if they're going to gag me or medicate me or what. But she said, there's a gentleman down the hall. Here we go. And he wanted me to ask you, would you please not stop singing? Look at here, oh God. At midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises to God, and the prisoners heard them. That man had been told that he had inoperable cancer and he was fixing to die. So when I found out that what I was doing was going to be helping somebody, I cut loose, buddy, and I sang. I literally sang for 2 days, didn't I, honey? They had me on medication. They had me on medication where I could not sleep because they was afraid I was going to die. They didn't want me to go sleep. I sung and I sung and I sung, and there, I don't know how many floors was that hospital. People would come down and say, are you the one that's singing? Are you the singer?
Yeah.
I said, yes. They said, well, you sing this song. Next thing, I'd have people all in the room.
Yeah.
And the Lord raised a testimony of His delivering power.
Hallelujah.
From the time I went in there. It took 14 people to move me and roll me, to change me when I first went in. And the first night, the guy that come to give me an air mattress, said, he brought it. Then the night right before that I left, I had lost about 250 pounds by that point. And he said, he was throwing out the order, he said, Combs. Freddie Combs, are you the guy they brought in about 3 weeks ago? I said, yes. He said, I cannot believe you're alive.
Yeah, come on, brother.
He said, you were black and blue. Did he say it?
Uh-huh.
I said, I'm alive. I said, Jesus spared my life.
Yeah.
He gave me another chance. And I cannot tell you how many times, and the people that worked with me, the many nurses, the aides and everybody that worked with me, they would come back because they were on rotation on different floors. They would come back and they would say, are you Freddie? Did they do it?
Yeah.
They didn't even recognize me. The Lord had done such a great work in me. If you've ever got a chance to see any of the TV stuff, I've given the picture of me in the hospital to be shown on television. They showed, as a matter of fact, I think they showed it on X Factor. But I want you to know that no matter what you're walking through, and I'm going to just start singing here in a minute and just let the Lord just bless your heart. But no matter what you're going through, Speak His name into every situation of your life. If you ain't got enough money at the end of the month, speak His name. We got to be good stewards, but speak His name. If you've got a little cold, don't worry about keeping up with that thing and trying to medicate that thing. They ain't no cure for that common cold. They ain't got none. They're just what you wasting your money. Speak His name. Oh my God. There's healing in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I told him this morning, I said, this here is dirty gold. That's dirty. That's real. It's about the only piece of real gold we've got left. We've had to turn everything. That's about the only piece of real gold we've got left. But that's dirty gold. You know why? Because the gold in heaven is as clear as glass.
Clear.
You know, when they purify gold, they heat it up and melt it to burn the dross off of it.
Yeah, yeah.
Can you imagine how pure that gold is if it's clear as glass?
Yes.
Walls of jasper, streets of gold, and the gate, there's gates to the city, and the gate is are of a single pearl.
Woo!
If any of you have ever studied how tall the gates of heaven are, they're huge. They're bigger than this.
Yeah.
One single pearl.
One pearl.
That's a big oyster. I dreamed of a city called glory.
Never be held in our hands. May I have your attention? I want want to introduce to you in this corner of the good and the right stands a champion robed in white. His height exceeds the heavens, his weight outweighs the world, his reach reaches everywhere, his age is this king who wore their crown, and they gladly watched the champion going down. Oh, but I will never count him out, for I'm a witness of the day he arose to retain the title.
For all who see, so I will.
will worship you on bended knee.
Tell me what you see.
with your tender touch. Lord, I need you so much to change me now. The seeds I've sown, the deeds I've done. Is anybody feel this way? By the power.
Decision, and the adversary says, "Give."
and you're standing in that valley of decision. And the adversary says, give up and give in. You've got to hold on. Jesus will show, and he will take you through the fire again. You've got to hold on. The Lord is going to show.
We have a hymn of invitation. What number do you call it, Boy?
307.
307.